friends, in this video I'm trying to get this lock find from Julian open. It's an old Avis 8550 which I found on a German island called Sylt. So I guess it was 1 year outside in the environment, so salt water, sand, wind, rain, whatever, and he bathed it 1 week in WD-40. When I got it and unpacked the package yesterday, the shackle wasn't moving at all. I got it a little bit moving by rattling around, but far apart from, or far away from moving here. So let's try it out. I don't expect the best. Even the core moved a little bit. See, I have a little additional light here, so that you can see well. Okay, hope it's not too much in my way. Okay, I'm trying to go bottom of a kiwi. Oh, core is really not turning that well. So let's see how it goes. Was pin 1, tiny little fault set here. Pin 2, not that much onto it. 3, okay, little click. 4, 5 seems okay. 5 gave a little deeper fault set here. Something, I think on 2, okay, phew. This pick is definitely not deep enough. Let's try the other one. Okay, and this is too deep to get the pins at the back, okay. Okay, I think I got pin 2, but not the back pins. Okay, got my fault set back. Let's check again. 1. I think yes. Might be something on 2. Or is that 1 oversetting? Don't really know. No, 3 is deep down. Can't reach 4. Let's check 4. Okay. Didn't sound too bad. Touched 5. Okay. 1 feels pretty okay. Gives a little bit. I try to loosen the tension as good as possible. No. 2 seems okay. 3 is not going. Even I got here some count rotation on 5. There's no way, okay. I was just saying there's no way I can set something, okay. Here's something on number 2. Come on. Okay, jetzt oben. Wow. Wow, really, really nasty. and I have to hold it open. So let's see. Oh. As expected, I'm trying something. And tape that thing to a lock. Maybe we can use a bit of force here. Okay, so tension wrench is not moving, doesn't look too nice. Okay, the shackle is clearly moving a bit, and you can see here the cut. Hope you can see that well. There's a bit of a cut here. But it... No. Okay, got a bit more out. Maybe. Wow. I think WD-40 doesn't really work on such rotten locks, and there's no way I can get something like a shim here inside without cutting into my fingers. No, there's no way. Maybe here. These 85s are normally really easy to pick, but a pretty good lock. No. Oh, very sadly, there is no way I got the shackle free a bit more. Lock is still open. Can try to turn it a bit more here, but yeah. But I have something harder than WD-40, and will bar the lock in it maybe for some days. And this stuff even got my old Lockwood going. It was still a very hard lock, and you can see the key is still turned. I have to re-oil it pretty good, but all the pins were stuck, and there was so much crust and dirt inside. By the way, it's a lock from Michael Meenert. I got I think half a year or a year ago. This one was really tough and very hard to get open, and I hope I can get this shackle open here someday. But anyway, a very nice find, and a nice surprise. And a cool lock at all. I really like these Abus 85s, and yeah, I will show you in a future video if I've got it open. And so just 10 minutes later, and with my still picked here, and with my trusty old Caramba Super Plus, I got it really open, and wow, it was really a fight. These end pieces were stuck like crazy in the lock. Rusted, and you can see how nasty it looks. But now I can clean it up nicely. At least, I don't know if you can see this. Try to shine the light in. The left locking pole is at least moving a little bit. Yes, it's moving. You can probably see. But wow. I have a little flashlight here in addition. Just wait a second. Okay, just look into this. And I really did give it a good shot of this Caramba Super Plus. But it was rusted inside this hole here. You can see the locking pole on this side, and all the rust, and wow. But the cutouts are actually pretty nice and deep and straight. Really a good quality lock here. Even it doesn't have ball bearings. I'm pretty happy. This was really a nice surprise, and a cool find from Tobias and Julian, and so once again, thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.